Well, new COMELEC Chairman George Garcia looking to implement reforms of the poll body. He also vows that COMELEC will remain impartial and independent. Chairman Garcia now joins us here on the program. Chairman, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Good afternoon, Ma'am Carmina, and good afternoon to all the televiewers of your program.
Right. Things have been said about the many reforms that the COMELEC needs at this point. Question now is, how much of a reformer will you be, Chairman?
Definitely will push to the limit whatever reforms are necessary for purposes of ensuring that future electoral exercises will be orderly, free, and at the same time independent. So meaning we have to ensure that the commission election will always be independent and impartial. At the same time, that we must be able to ensure that the laws that we are going to implement and execute are updated laws, not necessarily laws which are already outdated and can no longer answer the questions of the modern time. And so what we're going to do is to push for legislation that we believe will honestly initiate reforms within and without or outside the commission elections.
But already, Chairman Garcia, you're already being criticized for the new COMELEC building that you want to be built. How will this benefit the public ultimately, and why is there seemingly a sense of urgency to build this new COMELEC building?
Yes, ma'am. For the information of everybody, we have been leasing several offices, several floors of the different buildings, including warehouses. And if you're going to total or summarize all the expenses incurred for purposes of leasing this property, it would cater indeed to the benefit of the public that the COMELEC will have its own building rather than spending a lot of money for purposes of renting the different places. So number one, number two is just for us to properly coordinate and synchronize all our actions, especially if you are just housed in one building. We have a three-hectare property at Macapagal Avenue, and sayang naman po yung property na if that will be cannot be utilized. Nasa amin na yon ever since several years ago, and perhaps it's really high time that we start building the edifice or building the home of the commissioner election.
Pero ano po ang pakinabang ng publiko dito?
Yes, ma'am. It will practically makakatipid ang sobra ang publiko. Number two po, masisigurado namin ang integrity at credibility ng aming lahat ng ginagawa. Try to imagine if you will have your own warehouse for all your machines, for all your equipment in-house in one place, very far from Manila. Nandun po sa Santa Rosa, we have a warehouse in the Pilpos. So medyo magkakahiwalay po, and it's very difficult to monitor. So will that benefit the public? Definitely and surely. Because during the election, lagi na lang kine-question, we cannot watch whatever the COMELEC is doing. So kung nasa isang area lang po kami, magagawa po namin lahat at ma-ensure namin ng transparency. But I would like to guarantee our people, Ma'am Carmina, na this is not the primary goal of the commission election. This is secondary. Reforms pa rin po, good governance pa rin ang primary aspiration namin. Ang sa akin lang po, perhaps it's high time, maybe a matter of a little amount can do for purpose of starting it. It can be built for 10 years. It can be built for 12 years. Mas start lang po. We are fully aware of the economic crisis that we have right now, especially the need for money to finance our pandemic response. And that's why ayaw namin sumabay do sa mga problema po na yon. We only brought that up simply because of look at what happened when the fire got in certain part of the COMELEC space, COMELEC office. So maybe pinag-isipan na po namin dati pa yon, baka naman pwedeng ma-push under this administration.
Mm-hmm. Chairman, you mentioned a while ago that you will actively push for legislation that will aid you in the reforms that you want to happen within the commission. But will these pieces of legislation actually address the lack of trust the public has in the commission?
Yes, ma'am. I will guarantee that definitely mawawala na yung mistrust ng tao, hopefully, sa ating commissioner election. We were able to do that in the 2022 election, and we promise to likewise actively do that again in the 2025 and the four other forthcoming electoral exercises. So ano pong ibig sabihin? The hands of the commissions are so tied in the past electoral exercises simply because there were no legislations allowing us to do further, to move further and to act further. Ano pong ibig sabihin? We have a 1985 omnibus election code. 1985 comparing now to 2022, definitely yung panahong yun, ma'am, manual election pa, batas ang pambansa pa, yung minimension doon. Now, if we're going to revise, not only amend the omnibus election code, surely we can do everything legally possible as mandated by the Constitution, such as, for example, the computerization of the election. Number two, yung mga sinasabi before, ensuring that all those who are candidates will have to appear in COMELEC debates. Halimbawa, wala po tayong legislation, but so if we can amend or revise our present laws, then all of these things will be properly remedied.
You talked about computerization, Chairman, but in 2016, you questioned Smartmatic over discrepancies in the electronically transmitted COCs. You were then the lawyer of then VP candidate Senator Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Now that you're COMELEC chairman, will you see to it that the relationship the COMELEC has with Smartmatic is terminated?
I cannot preempt whatever action Ma'am Carmina with the COMELEC and bank will be doing as far as the conduct of bidding in the future is concerned, such as, for example, we really have to answer the question, are we really going to do away with our 90,000 vote counting machines? Yung mga pumalpak, yung mga luma na, are we going to have new supplier for the vote counting machine? What are the specifications that we are going to lay down as far as the new machines are concerned? And how much are we going to allot for purposes of having new machines, for example, for the 2025 election? These are the questions which really will have to be discussed. But I will guarantee the public, the stakeholders, they will have a part in any decision that the COMELEC will be doing as far as the computerization of the 2025 and future elections are concerned.
There are suggestions that maybe we can go hybrid, maybe go back to manual. Some are saying that just to ensure transparency, just so the public can see what is actually transmitted.
Personally, I had been supporting the hybrid system of election when Senator Aimee Marcos was then the chairperson of the Committee on Electoral Reforms of the Senate. We were able to pass the legislation, at least as far as the Senate is concerned, but there was no sufficient time. That's why it was set aside. But next time that Congress will pursue with the hybrid system of election, definitely, at least personally, I will support that, and I will try to convince the members of the commission, the other commissioners, the NBank, that we should likewise support this system because this ensures greater transparency. Hindi lang po sapat na natatransmit natin ng mabilis ang result. Dapat yung natatransmit natin ay accurate and the people can really see that their votes are being counted.
Tell me something, Chairman Garcia. When you were an election lawyer, what did you see that made you question the system, and what do you intend to do with it now that you're chairman of the COMELEC?
The lack of transparency. From the first phase to the last phase of proclaiming the winner, we will have to ensure that the public will always be informed, that all stakeholders will have not only being able to observe, but will have complete participation for purposes of at least ensuring a credible and honest election. Transparency is the key, and accountability is likewise the key. We have to ensure that. Otherwise, regardless of all the efforts that the COMELEC will give to ensure an honest and credible election, if the people does not believe not only on our credibility, not only on the system that we are putting in place, then we will not be able to get that support from the commission, from the people, and from the entire nation in general.
Okay, I want to talk now about PDP Laban. We know about the division level decision. When is the ANBAG expected to come out with their decision regarding the legitimacy of the PDP Laban, the question on the legitimacy of the Pimentel-led PDP Laban faction?
Yes, Ma'am Carmi, I think there are not only three or five cases that need the immediate resolution by the Commission on Election. One is, of course, the PDP Laban controversy, and the other cases involving party lists and such other major local controversies. I will definitely convince the members of the Commission, the one who are to write the decision, to immediately come up with a decision. The problem, Ma'am Carmina, is as of this time, we're only 5 members of the commission, the chairman and the 4 commissioners. Supposedly, we should have been 7 members of the NBank. There are certain cases, and I do not want to preempt or tell you whether that will involve the case of PDP Labat. Mm. There are certain cases where the voting is tied. For example, 2 in favor and 2 and against. Mm. Even if the chairman will vote in either of the side, then we will not have a majority. In the case of Australia versus the Comelec, the Supreme Court clarified that there must always be 4 votes in the commission. So I will have to look into whether these are the same, or the one that you are mentioning, the case, the PDP Laban case, is one of the cases whereby the voting is a split one.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but if in case the Onbank reverses its division level decision, what's going to happen to the Kusi faction?
I cannot yet at this point, ma'am, tell you whatever will happen, because that will depend on the disposition of the NBank in the resolution. The resolution likewise and should always contain whatever will happen after the decision is promulgated. So at this point, ma'am, I do not want to preempt that by answering your question, simply because whoever will be the losing party in the NBank case will definitely have another remedy. And if I'm going to answer your question, it might dictate to the other losing party whatever the remedy is, or it might likewise be prejudicial to the winning party.
Understood. Let's go now to the House of Representatives. Chairman Garcia, as you know, there now is a bill against turncoatism. How will this help or aid in the reforms that you want to happen in the whole electoral system?
Definitely, ma'am, it's a great help. During the time of former Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago, she already proposed that piece of legislation, although it did not materialize. It never went into that legislative mill. However, this time, hopefully, that should at least merit the attention of the members of Congress. Napaka-importante po yon. Why? Because sa amin po, usually, Ma'am Carmina, nagkaka-problem tayo when it comes to the period of substitution. Yung period ng substitution natin, you were once before a member of this party, and just because you wanted to substitute in the candidate of the other party, then you are going to change your party affiliation. That is very, very problematic. That would usually raise a lot of questions and a lot of cases will be filed. In order to prevent cases from the Comelec being flooded with all of these cases of issues of substitution, then this is the right time using this law as our basis.
Mm. What about the party list law? I mean, no less than the former president Duterte has also said that not only has it been mocked in so many words, but that, you know, rich families or at least scions of political dynasties have actually found the back door to be able to enter the House of Representatives. Go ahead.
Definitely, Ma'am Carmina, definitely I will push for the amendment of Republic Act 7941 or the party list. Napakatagal na po na batas na yan. And let's face it, perhaps there is truth to the saying that it's being bastardized by certain sectors, or it's being abused by certain groups, yung party list law natin, simply because the law is so general, the law is not that specific. At the same time, there are several loopholes of that law, when in fact even our Supreme Court had changed its decision from this decision to another decision because of the absence of the law which will plug the loopholes in Republic Act 7941. Mm-hmm. When the proper time comes, especially if somebody will try to file an amended bill or a bill amending the Republic Act 7941 or the party list law, I will guarantee you, as the chairman, I will actively participate in such a deliberation. I'll try to convince the members of Congress that first and foremost, the primary purpose of the party list law is to ensure greater participation of the marginalized and the underrepresented. Marginalized and underrepresented. The law should ensure that.
Chairman Garcia, you have said that you will be independent. You've said that many times, that you will be needing the support of President Marcos to institutionalize all these reforms that you've just mentioned. How confident are you that you will get the support of your former client?
Not only, ma'am, that I'm going to get the support or ask for the support. Maniligawan ko po ang ating Pangulo when it comes to electoral reforms. But definitely, it's an entire legislative process, meaning from the House of Representatives, even to the Senate of the Philippines, and of course to the Executive Department. I'll try to explain why this proposed bill, why this proposed measure is needed by the Commission of Election and needed to ensure transparency, accountability, ensuring that democracy will be alive through election. And therefore, we will be needing definitely budget. We will be definitely needing new laws. And then again, we'll be needing the teeth to implement these laws. Ako naman po naniniwala ako na napakaganda ng agenda ng ating Pangulo when it comes to at least reforming a lot of things in this country. And electoral reform, I think, is one of those in the agenda.
Mm-hmm. At ano pong masasabi ninyo doon sa mga hindi pa rin po naniniwala sa inyo? At ano pa rin po ang masasabi ninyo doon sa mga nagsasabi po na kaya nyo po magagawa itong lahat ng reformang ito ay dahil lang po dati nyong kliyente si Pangulong Marcos?
Ang reform naman po ay hindi lamang nakadepende sa isang tao. Hindi lang po nakadepende sa isang pinuno. Ang reforma hindi lang sa isang institusyon katulad ng Commission of Election will depend on a lot of things, most especially doon sa mga tao na naandyan mismo sa institution. Before reforming anybody else or anything else, the Commission of Election within must reform itself. Our people, our society, our purpose. We have to reform everything. Diyan po dapat magsisimula yan. The President will only help us if we can show to the President, we show to the Executive, show to the Legislative our firm desire to reform whatever we are going to do. Yung pampera ng bayan, nagagastos namin ng tama. Yung bang pag-hold namin ng conduct na election talaga bang impartial? So, yung pong reform hindi lamang po sa relationship namin ni Presidente kahit pa former sa lahat-lahat. And so, doon sa mga may doubt, tama po yun naman yung inyong doubt sa akin. Tama rin naman po na mag-entertain kayo ng mga agam-agam. But try to give us an opportunity. At least when I was a commissioner of the Commission of Election, modestly, I said I was able to prove that I can separate my profession with what is really good for the country. We were able to hold a very clean and honest election, regardless of the belief of anybody or somebody. But at least give us an opportunity to prove that it's not only a one-man commission, it's a collegial body, and mine is only one vote. Mm-hmm.
And is that your way of saying that moral reform is needed in the COMELEC, Chairman?
Definitely, ma'am. Definitely, moral reform is a must in this institution.
And we're going to have to leave it at that. COMELEC Chairman George Garcia, thanks for joining us today. Take care. Keep safe.